We know we're very vulnerable as a country or as a continent. It's about time we start up to start developing those capabilities to ensure the security of our people.
We're at an inflection point as a country, so there are a number of transitions that are going on at the same time. So there's a multitude of both behavioral and environmental factors that globally is really leading to this increased incidence of outbreaks.
Everybody worldwide now is looking at health as a security issue.
Essentially, what we're trying to do today is to establish or launch an alliance, right, that brings together both the public and private sector and focuses on strengthening the country's detection, preparedness, and response capacity.
Seeing how the private sector across board can support the work that we lead on behalf of the Nigerian people. So it's not just supporting NCDC's work, it's what are we doing on behalf of the Nigerian people.
We have a mixed and dynamic healthcare system, both public and private sector, which is quite unique for Nigeria. We have a very high proliferation of private facilities.
Leverage on the very wide reach, knowledge, expertise, and collaborative instinct of the private sector is the main purpose of today. A successful meeting today will be one where unthought of concepts and innovations emerge from just rethinking what the challenges are.
NCDC has also helped states to develop plans to respond to outbreaks of diseases.
Healthcare is a viable investment option, and there are healthcare solutions that can reach market to unlock the potential for achieving our health outcome.
Against future epidemics or outbreaks. The alliance is really a partnership between NCDC on the government part and the Private Sector Health Alliance of Nigeria. And I think both parties have an important role to play. I think from where I sit, it is the role of the alliance to help broker some of these discussions. I believe today there are about 55 corporates that had sent in their confirmation to come, and I think that's what this is about.
Government would also welcome more active private sector participation in the transfer of much needed technical know-how, skills, and especially craftsmanship to Nigerian youths at middle and basic level by setting up or supporting relevant institutions all over the country.
That period in the history of Nigeria, I think, will go down as a truly memorable one when all Nigerians came together in unity and we saw what we could do, where we have the will, where we have unity within the private and the public sector.
I saw a lot of leadership commitment.
It happened in Lagos and Rivers State, two of the most viable states in this country.
But in terms of what we've been done, what we've been doing at the foundation to support this Ebola crisis, we spent over ₦1 billion over a year and a half.
The key again is building a proper health system involving both the private sector and public sector.
Here in Nigeria, we were able to support with about over 10 pickup vans, ambulances, and consumables and personal protective equipment to the treatment centers, both here in Lagos and in Port Harcourt.
So the fear was palpable. People's lives stopped. And we see what a health emergency like that can do to a nation.
So we have to come together to use our combined resources to build our expertise, and it cannot be left to the public sector alone.
How can you help government innovate? How can you maintain infrastructure? And how can you maintain those services that really the private sector should be able to maintain?
Our founder, Mr. Tony Elmelu, was one of the first private sector stakeholders to commit the sum of ₦100 million to fight the Ebola outbreak.
With MTN Foundation, we work with a number of a private organization.
So we know it's not just Facebook, there's WhatsApp, there's Instagram, and so we know that the power of all of those platforms can reaches billions of people around the world, and in Nigeria, tens of millions of people.
We have interactions with doctors, with pharmacists, with nurses, with patient medicine. We have a huge data that partnership with pharma industry will really help.
So we're focused very much on how can we partner with government, how can we partner with other organizations to amplify the reach of our platforms.
And so please join us in this effort, and I can assure you that the new leadership in the NCDC working with private sector allowance will keep you sleeping properly without bothering about one virus outside the window.